Well, hello to everybody. I am Sotiria Dimopoulou. I am a PhD candidate of classical archaeology at the University of Münster. I'm writing about the cult group of Damophon at Lykosura in Arcadia. And today I'm going to present you the vial of Despoina. This is a map of the ancient Peloponnese and Arcadia. This is Lykosura here. Lykosura was a very important religious center with the Temple of Despoina and the Mysteries, which took place on them. This is a graphic about the Temple of Despoina and the buildings around it with the stoa, the peribolos, the stoa with Doric columns, some altars in front of the temple, and the Doric temple with Doric columns, a pronaos, a mainaos, and the cella. I must mention that the temple has various chronologically phases from 4th BC until the Roman years. And these were the stairs. From the stairs watched the initiators, the mysteries, which took place at Lykosura. The mysteries were very close to the mysteries of the Eleusis. And these are the remains from the temple today. This is the cella. This is the mosaic in front of the cella. And these are the stones where the cult group of Damophon was located. Damophon was the sculptor of the group. And apart from the archaeological evidence, and Pausanias, of course, a very important literary source, he describes in his 8th book about the cult group and Arcadia, we have this coin. This is a coin which was found in Megalopolis. It's the only exemplar in German, I'm sorry. It is dated in 200 AD to the years of Julia Domna, whose head is illustrated on its averse. And on its reverse, you can see the cult group, if you can see the details enough, I'm not sure, but it is destroyed enough and we are not sure how they were dressed or what they were carrying, they were holding. And this is a reconstruction from the cult group, from Andrew Stewart. This is Despoina. Despoina was the main goddesses at Lykosura. She was dressed in fine garments, as you can see. This famous vial over her head, into her knees, and a chiton who was also decorated. She was holding the ritual cista and the scepter. Next to her was sitting Demetra, her mother, with a torque. And next to Demetra was standing Artemis with a torque and snakes or dragons. We are not able to see the dragons. And I must mention that Artemis was the sister of Despoina. And on the left from the group was standing Anytos. Anytos was a Titan, according to Pausanias, and he grew up Despoina, according to the Arcadian mythos. Anytos was represented in a warrior's attitude, according to Dickens. And this is the garment, the famous cult dress from Despoina. I don't know if we have here two different garments or one piece. I am not sure, because it seems like to be consisted of two pieces. The garment is 113 meter high. It is exhibited in the National Archeological Museum at Athens, and it is the only fragment that we have. And let's see now the zones. The first zone, the upper zone, I must say that this zone, for me, it's not the top of the garment. The garment goes further, higher. It is decorated with ornaments, but it is destroyed enough, it is hard to see. The next zone has eagles and thunderbolts. This zone is related to the cult of Zeus. whose cult was very extended, especially on Lycaon Mountain. The third zone is decorated with olive leaves and its fruits, and as you can see, each zone is bordered through lines. This is very interesting. And a very, very nice zone, an excellent zone from the upper part of the garment, is the so-called sea thiasos, the sea world. Here are represented tritons, nereids, and dolphins. You can see here a naked triton who is touching a dolphin. He looks like he's having a discussion with it. And on his back is sitting a nereid. He is also naked with a himation, and the tail of the triton is very large. An excellent figure from the same zone, a nereid. She is riding a sea chitos, a sea dragon. She is half naked in a profile view. She is wearing a himation who falls into her knees. She has a topknot. The characteristics of her face are very clearly, as well as from the dragon. This zone, the topic of the zone, is related to the cult of Poseidon. Poseidon was the father of Despoina after the rape of Demeter, and he was the god of the source water, of the water, and of the underworld in Peloponnese too. And between the upper and the lower part, here, you can see fringes, and these fringes seems to be the edge of the upper part. That's why I am saying that perhaps it consists of two pieces. The next zone from the upper part, from the lower part, I'm sorry, is the largest, the biggest, and it is the so-called Nike zone. We have here Nikes, who are flying, who have open wings, who are in profile view. This one, who are carrying censers as cult objects, as ritual objects. This one is like walking through the line towards the garment. She is represented between bay leaves, and she is dressed in fine garments. Another figure from the same zone, and another one. She is moving less than the other. I think this is because the surface of the marble. This zone is very interesting because I think that it is related to the victory of life against the death, of the nature, of the euphoria of the land, because the two goddesses of Lykosura, Demeter and Despoina, were represented the nature and the underworld too. And the last and most bizarre and interesting zone, which its origins, I think, goes back to the Mycenaean years. Well, I think that here we have human beings with animal masks. Some researchers believe that they are animals with human dresses, but I think that they are, yes, that they are women with animal masks. They are leading a dance procession, a ritual ceremony before the initiation to the mysteries of Despoina. They are playing an instrument, a flute or a double flute, and they are dancing. It's like an orgiastic dancing as well as the Dionysos rituals. We have bears, goats, donkeys, as you can see very clearly. And here, this animal is playing the double flute. And at the bottom of the garment, you see the meander. At this point, I would like to present you two other fragments, which I located at Lykosura Museum. We have here Nikes, but these Nikes are not carrying censers. They are holding their dresses. I don't know if you can see that. And the fragments are decorated, are having the same decoration as the garment, the cult garment. We have leaves here. Again, I am not sure if those two fragments belong to the same garment or to the chiton of Despoina, because the chiton of Despoina has the same decorations as the mantle or the vial or appendages. I am not sure what is about, what is the gall garment. And at last, the graphic reconstruction, you can see here very clearly all the zones. The first one, yes, with the eagles and thunderbolts, the leaves, and the zone with the sea theatres. You can see here clearly all the figures, the fringes, and here the zone with the Nikes. The other two Nikes are here. I have the Nikes here, this zone. Design, because I don't know, I am not sure if those two figures, they are different as the others, but they belong to the same subject, the same topic. And at last you see the beautiful animals at the bottom of the who are playing instruments. They are lovely, but I am not sure what the figure four fear. I'm almost ready. The number four, I am not sure what animal is this, or if it's a woman who is playing some. I'm not sure. I don't know. Perhaps you will help me. Thank you.